10 children. So please, at least 10 children will come, we will start. Please note down in the notebook, no book is required. So definite article is the THE. So first of all, when you use the definite article, as I told you, when you personally want to identify the person or object, we use definite article. So I told you about article. Article is a type of adjective which is used to give more information about the noun. So articles are two. One is definite, one is indefinite. So indefinite are A and N. Definite is the. So when indefinite is used, we have discussed that day. Today we will talk about definite article. Definite article. Okay. So definite article, when we are using to talk about things, first condition. When we want to talk about something, we are using the definite article. Or to identify a thing or a person, we are talking about two conditions. Under two conditions, we are using the definite article. Example, I have bought the house. You saw last year. I bought the house, you saw last year. You see, children, this analyze this sentence. I bought the house. It is full sentence, but you saw last year means the particular house you saw, I bought. So I have used the definite article here. The. I have bought the house you saw last year. Means I did not buy any other house. I bought the house you saw. Means I am particularly telling about one particular house. So I have used the definite. Yes, Hina Chaudhary asked. Any doubt is there? Okay, you ask. You raise your hand, no, you should ask. Okay, Nirav, present. Then you see, then you will see the condition. So first of all, rule I wrote, articles are two types, definite and indefinite. So that day we talked about definite article, today we are talking about indefinite article. So indefinite article is the THE. Okay. So one example I have given, I have bought the house you saw last year. So I am identifying the house you saw, a particular house. So I am using the definite article. I saw a house, any house. So I saw a house, any house. So it is indefinite article. But I am using the, because I want to point out to the house you saw, which I bought. That's why I am using the definite article. Okay, now we will see other conditions when we are using the definite article. This side it is clear, no, I will write this side. Number one. So, we use the to mean the person or thing. Talked about. This is first rule. So, I was giving you example that day. Call for a doctor and call for the doctor. Call for a doctor means any doctor I told. That means one particular doctor who has treated you. So this is the same condition. We use the to mean the person or thing. Talked about. About what, whom we are talking about. We mean it. Number one. Then you saw for some other example, let us see. Have you met the boy? means not all boys. I am telling have you met the boy means I am referring to one particular boy only. So I am using the definite article. Give me the book. Give me the book I gave you yesterday. If I tell, I am talking about definite article. The train has come. The train means not any train. I am talking about the train for which I was waiting. So I am using the definite article. So this condition is fulfilled. We use the to mean the person thing talked about which we are talking about. One condition. Second one. Second one is to generalize a class. To generalize a class. Example. See the example. What example you can give for it? Okay. So the cow is a woolly animal. Here in indefinite also we have read that we can generalize means all cows. The cow refers to all the cows. The crow is black. Means I am referring to all the crows. I am using the definite article. Second condition is this. Third condition. Before adjectives. Before adjectives. Indicating a nationality or class. Or class. Example. Before adjectives indicating a nationality or class, we are using the definite article. What is the example? For example, when I say help the poor, so I am talking about all poor people. So I am using the definite article the. Help the poor. Or the Indian villages are beautiful. Here you see, I talked about one particular country, India. So I used the definite article before the noun. I talked about, suppose English countryside is full of mountains. The English I have to use because I am talking about one particular country only. So I am using the. Clear? Second condition and third condition is fulfilled. First of all, we use to mean the person or thing. Second one, to generalize a class. Third, before adjectives indicating a nationality or class. Nationality, Indian nationality, English nationality. Because I am referring to all the Indians, all the country in India as a whole, I am using the.
Sir, please tilt the camera downwards.
Okay. Downwards, you see, I will rub and write because touching the camera is no. I am writing in the top again. You please note here. Okay. Because if I adjust the camera, another picture will come. Suppose example, help the poor. Help the poor. So I am talking about poor only. So I am using the definite article.
So another thing.
Yes. Indian.
Sir.
Yes. Are nice. Suppose I will not write beautiful, I will write nice. mean same thing. Suppose I will say the English countryside is beautiful. The Norwegian people are good. About one nationality or class I talked. So I am using the definite article. Our rule 3 is fulfilled. Okay. Let us go to rule 4. Rule number 4. Yes.
Sir, what are you written after nish?
After
indicating a.
Indicating a. Nationality. Nationality or class. Nationality means India. The person who lives in India is called Indian. The person in Pakistan is called Pakistani. The person of Bangladesh is called Bangladeshi. This is nationality. A person of England is called English. So this is his nationality. Indicating a nationality or class. Nationality or class. So nationality, I told the Indian villages are nice. Means about Indian nationality I talked. Our English countryside is beautiful. About England I talked. So I used the definite article. Shall we go to next rule? Rule number 4, shall we go?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. Rule 3 is clear now. Rule 4. Let us go to rule number 4. Okay. Who use before? A superlative adjective. So, example, good, better, best. Okay, worst. So, these are degrees of comparison. Good, better, best. So, when I am talking about a superlative degree, I am using the definite article. Okay. Superlative degree. So, in adjective, now you might have read about, you will read about degree of comparison. This is number 4 rule, number 5 rule, used before gulfs, rivers, okay, mountains, etc. You are not telling Himalayas, you are telling the Himalayas. Da Jamuna, Da Ganga. So before reverse, you are using the definite article. Okay. Example, Da Bay of Bengal. So before the name of the ocean, I used definite article. Similarly, before name of mountains, okay, the Gulf of Kutch, the Indian Ocean, the Himalayas, I am using the definite article. So, definite article is used before the gulfs, rivers, mountains, etc. That I use. Okay, clear? Number 4 rule is clear, 5 rule is clear. Who used before superlative, adjective? Here, superlative is good. Kinder. Suppose beautiful, more beautiful. Beautiful, beautifuler will not be there. Kinder will not be there. More kind. Beautiful, more beautiful. So, this is the use of the proper language. Beautiful, you cannot make it more beautifuler. You have to tell beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Okay. Harder, hardest. Harder is the superlative degree, there I use the definite article. Here also, fifth rule is mobilized before the name of gulfs, before the name of rivers, before the name of mountains also I use the definite article. Clear? Write down, we will go to the next rule. Rule number 6. Let us go to rule number 6. We use before a proper noun. If there is any adjective before it, for example, proper noun means name, Ram, Hari, Ashok. So, Ashoka the Great. Ashoka the Great. So, how are you telling the great king Ashoka? The great king Ashoka. So this is right. So Ashoka the Great. But we are telling as the great king Ashoka. So da is used before the. This is the proper noun. Okay. So before proper noun and adjective is used, so I use the definite article. Before the proper noun Ashoka, one adjective is used, so I use the definite article the. Another example I will give. The police Kalidas. Kalidas, you know, he was the great fool. So the police Kalidas. So before Kalidas, I used the adjective police. So I am using the definite article. The police, the great king Ashoka, the police Kalidas, I am using the definite article D. Okay. Okay, okay. I will give attendance before 5 minutes. Don't worry. Then let us go to rule number 7. Rule number 7.
Sir.
The great king Ashoka, the police Kalidas.
Okay. Sir, you have one.
What happened?
Sir, आप वन मिटा दो पर ये मत करिए.
Okay, I am waiting. The great king Ashoka, the prince Kalidas. I have robbed, but I am telling you right now, the great king Ashoka. Another example, the prince Kalidas. We are using the definite article before it.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, आपने अभी fifth वाले point में गलत लिखा था.
कहा
सर? जैसे हम लिखते हैं ना डिग्रीज, पॉजिटिव, कंपैरेटिव, सुपरलेटिव.
हाँ हाँ.
तो सुपरलेटिव थर्ड वाला होता है, आपने सेकंड वाला बताया है.
ओके, बिफोर बिफोर द सुपरलेटिव. ओके ओके, करेक्ट. यू मेक इट करेक्ट. ओके, फर्स्ट वन इज सुपरलेटिव. गुड, बेटर, बेस्ट, व्हिच इज द सुपरलेटिव?
Sir, best.
Ah, yes, best. okay, superlative positive compare, okay, okay, you are correct. Positive comparative superlative. Positive good. Comparative better. Superlative best. Ah, you are correct. Okay, children, when in blackboard I will write something, you please correct it like this. Welcome. Okay, no. So our example also will change. He is the best player. He is the best player. Please note down. Rectify this, children, and write the superlative properly. So rule number 6 is over. Shall we go to 7? And rubbing 6. He is the best player. Now let us go to next one. Now omission. Omission means where no article is required. Omission means no article is required. Please write down. Before common nouns, no article is required before common nouns. Okay. Examples. Women are kind. When I use the common noun, plural, cats mew. I have not used any article. Cats mew. Okay, women are kind in nature. Second rule, where omission means what? Where article is not required. Where article is not required, it is called omission. Omission means article is not required. Before name of particular people, before name of particular people, no article is required. Example I will give. Write down before name of particular people. Mr. Suppose why we will write their name. He is working as the so if you write one particular name, Mr. Amit, Mr. Ashok, Mr. Atul, Mr. Vinay, any name you write, there what will happen? You don't require article. So two example of omission while you are doing the unedited passage, it will help you. Okay. Shall I run?
No, sir.
Okay, I am waiting.
सर सेक यू रब द सेकंड पॉइंट और टच
आउट सिंपल मिस्टर ब्लैक आई पुट इट वर्किंग एज अ मैनेजर
सर नीचे वाली लाइन नहीं दिख रही
हां नीचे वाली ही बोल रहा हूं बिफोर नाउ मिस्टर ब्लैक आई मिस्टर आई हैव रिटन ब्लैक इज वर्किंग एज ए मैनेजर ओके Then you see, you don't use article because name before name of seasons. The spring, the autumn, we do not say. You do not use article before name of seasons. That is another example. Here also, before name of seasons. S-E-A-S-O-N-S, please write down. Before name of seasons also don't use the article. Before name of particular people you don't use article. Okay. Then before breakfast, lunch, dinner, we don't use article. What will I cook for
Sir,
breakfast?
Which you return after Mr. M.R.
Yes, if working as a manager, before name of seasons, you don't use article. This one also right here. Before name of seasons, you don't use article. Before name of seasons.
Please.
Okay.
Mr. is?
Mr. Des is working as a manager. He is working as a manager.
Thank you, sir.
We will go to the next point. Please note down. Seventh condition, where article is not required. Seventh. Before meals. Example, what shall I cook? For dinner. I am not telling for the dinner. Question mark. So before dinner, before breakfast, before lunch, definite article is not required. I don't like to have lunch late. So I told breakfast, lunch, dinner, supper. Before that, no article is required. That is another point. You don't use definite article before meals or meals before breakfast, before dinner, before lunch, before supper, you don't use definite article. Two examples I have given, what shall I cook for dinner, question mark, I don't like to have lunch late. Two examples I have given. Okay. Let us go to rule 8. Okay, rule 8. Before the name of the lessons. For example, he is my father, she is my sister, you are telling. You are not telling he is the father, like this. Father scolded me. mother told a story. So when we are writing this note, we are not using any article. Father, mother, brother, sister, we are not using any definite article. Before relations, we don't use any article. Example I have given, father scolded me. I did not say that father scolded me. Mother told a story. I did not say the mother told a story. So before that, no article is required. Then this side is blank. I will write rule number 8. So this side. Before a transitive verb. So before a, two types of verbs are there before a transitive verb. TRANSITIV. What happened? Before a transitive verb. So what is transitive verb? To hold breath, 2 plus verb, it is called transitive. Direct verb is intransitive. 2 plus verb. So when there is 2 is there before verb, you don't use any article. To take a bath. I am going to take a bath. I am not using any article. I am going to take a bath. So no article is required because the verb we are talking is a transitive verb. How do you know? Because 2 is there before the verb. Okay, this is rule number 9. Article is not required before a transitive verb. What is transitive verb? The verb before which 2 is used. 2, I am going to take a bath. You don't need any article. Okay, the next rule I will write after doubling this, you please note down. To take a bath, to listen to music, to listen to music. Okay. Then you see number 9. Suppose you are telling, I am going home by the bus or by bus, which is correct? I am going home by bus, which is correct? Or I am going home by the bus, which is correct? Who will say? I am going home by, yes, noted. You please tell me, suppose I will tell, I am going home by the bus or I am going home by bus, which is correct? Which is correct?
By bus.
Why? Because the phrase is a preposition followed by object, bus. So this is also a rule. When we use a, I will write this. Okay. When do we use a phrase? With a preposition, not required. Article is not required. Phrase is a preposition. So by bus. By is a preposition, I use the preposition. So no article is required. By train. By train, by plane, by bus, by boat. By foot, by bus, by foot I can say. At sunrise, so at by they are all prepositions. Before phrase with the preposition, if we use, if there is preposition before the phrase, you don't need any article. Clerk rule, I will say clerk rule, I will say before the months of the year. For the months of the year, you don't use article. Okay. Or date of the week. Dates of the week. You don't use any article. For example, last Monday, I was at Delhi. Last December, I went home. I am not using any article. Winter season is very short. So we have read altogether 10 rules. If you remember, in the use of article, you will never make mistakes. Okay. These 10 rules you remember, you will have no mistake in article anytime. Okay. Okay, children, you please see your notebook. I will again repeat this. So meanwhile, I am writing the name of the people who are there. 32 are there. So Hina Utkars. So in Anjali Utkars Chirag. Anjali, in WhatsApp you give attendance. Yes, yes, you tell, I will write. Rasmika, Aniket, whose I have written, you please don't give attendance again. Parth, Vivek, yes. Prithvi, Parth, Vivek, Prithvi. Nabin, Nirav, Saransh Priya, Saransh Priya, Kabya Kumud Chirag, Kabya Kumud Chirag. Okay, Utkarsh Dhimat Azram Hiral. Those who are coming regularly, I know. I will give attendance, don't worry. Okay, children, Deepansu. They are coming regularly. Others. Ritesh. Okay, children, any doubt is there? Any doubt is there? Time is up, otherwise we will end the class.
Okay. No doubt, sir.
Okay, fine. Nice, no doubt, children. Sir. Have a good day.
प्लीज एंजॉय.
थैंक यू सर.